News of the moment, Jalen Hurts transferring from Alabama to Oklahoma. He's already graduated, will be eligible to play next season and take the reins from Kyler Murray, who took the reins from Baker Mayfield. Look at Bill Plaschke in Plasma One right now. That is one self-satisfied man. All right, fine. We'll roll tape.
Unlike everybody else, there I will tell you where he should go. Oklahoma is the place for Jalen Hurts.
That would
Murray be gone. He
could
play right away there.
You're getting more
there.
Points today for saying it than you got last week for saying it. It's a great call. I will remind you, you were eliminated first in that show, but that's okay.
Yes.
We know you like the move. What does it do?
It was an obvious call, obviously. Lincoln Riley, the last two Heisman Trophy winners, a great offense. This puts Oklahoma back in the playoff next year. I can't say it makes them ahead of Clemson or Alabama because they've got two pretty good quarterbacks over there as well. But this changes everything for Oklahoma. They were, again, with Murray leaving, he moves right in. Jalen Hurts, 26-2 as a starter, recently won the SEC championship game for Alabama. The guy's a stud, and he'll change. Again, he puts them right back in the playoff.
Darius Spain, you agree?
Yeah, and I'm super excited about this, and I don't care about Oklahoma, and I don't really care about Jalen Hurts, but this guy handled what went down at Bama better than you could ever expect. So the opportunity for him to go somewhere and follow in the footsteps of two other guys who transferred there ended up being Heisman winners. We'll see what happens in the draft, but could be two back-to-back first-rounders. This is the perfect situation for somebody that ended up in a bad one and handled it well. I'm super happy.
All right, sure, it's a great story. Nobody's denying that, but I'll remember last season that Jalen Hurts was maybe the position that capped Alabama from being as good as they could be and then was replaced by Tua. Kevin Blackistone, do you think this makes Oklahoma the favorites next year?
No. It does not make them the favorites and makes Oklahoma what they have been the last few years because you mentioned it. These are two guys who transferred in before him as quarterback. And guess what? Went on to win the Heisman Trophy. So it gives him an opportunity to get on that platform. He doesn't have to go to a national championship game, but he gets on a platform, reestablishes his credentials as a starting quarterback on a national level, and maybe he can follow up and be the third Heisman winning quarterback to transfer into Oklahoma for Lincoln Riley.
And Bob Ryan.
Well, I can't add to the idea that he's going to help him. Of course he's going to help him. My first thought was, hey, saves on the recruiting budget, you know? You don't have to go out and recruit a quarterback now. They can save money, go out and get another lineman. I mean, this is the way of the world. Welcome to 2019, America. This is the way college sports are in both football and basketball now. And if you don't like it,
okay,
it's too bad because it's never going
to
change.
Well, speaking of welcome to 2019, here's another wrinkle in this. Austin Kendall. The report is Oklahoma is blocking him from becoming immediately eligible at West Virginia as a graduate transfer. This is allegedly within the new transfer rules, by the way, because West Virginia is a Big 12 school. He'd have to sit out a year if he did it in the conference. How does that sit with you, Sarah, especially viewing it through Hurts coming in via grad transfer?
Well, we know the SEC has fixed this rule. The Big 12 hasn't yet. So he actually needs approval from Oklahoma to play right away. The chances that they give it to him maybe just went up, right? Because they'll be so happy with themselves for landing Jalen Hurts. Maybe they'll be feeling a little bit kinder. But the idea that they have the power to do that when he's already graduated from their school and has eligibility left is a problem that should be fixed in the rules like the
KB.
SEC has done.
Well, hopefully the Alston versus NCAA lawsuit will fix all of this because none of these players who can talk about themselves as students and who coaches and athletic directors talk about as students should be treated anything differently than any other student. And I've yet to see a student at the University of Maryland who was not an athlete be able to go to whatever school he or she wishes to whenever they want to.
Bob Ryan.
Kevin, you're in danger of having your tongue cut out by the authorities. You use the word player instead of the proper term, as we well know, that hyphenated word to describe
student athlete is what you're trying to say. Yes, we all know there was a wicked
ball. Yeah, well,
there.
You know, that's it. Yeah. Yes, it is. This is absurd. This borders on hypocrisy, and they should be ashamed of themselves, Oklahoma.
Mm-hmm. And Bill Plaschke, you want a last word here?
Yeah, it's a terrible dichotomy. One hand, the transfer rule works really well for Jalen Hurts. On the other hand, Oklahoma abuses the transfer rule. Let the kid go. You got your quarterback. Let him
the
go.
The argument Lincoln Riley could make is this is within the rules. And to that, you would say what, Bill Plaschke?
I would say, yeah, but you know what? It's something's bigger than the rules sometimes. The kid's future is bigger than the rules. The kid's welfare is bigger than the rules. Give the kid a break.
Right.